Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Bakertron, and welcome to another game of Homeworld. Today we have a 2v2 on the map Talos Crossroads, which, yep, I've commented on this map before, I think. And it's fairly simple. We have resource pockets here, starting resources at the starting locations, and that's about it. So today our players will be down here in as the yellow player. This is PackofMarbs3, who we have seen before, I believe. I'm not sure if the video is still public, but yeah, that's really all I can say about him. And his ally over here, who's the yellow player in the strategic view, but the green player as the green colored player. This is Timelord, and we haven't seen him before, I think. And over here we have, actually I'm not sure which one this is. Okay, this is a slightly darker red, so I believe this is Adriko of FL, and his ally in the same FL clan. Yes, this is a sort of more ready red, I suppose. This is Reki, who we also have seen before, maybe even in the same game as Pack of Marbs, but once again I don't have that good a memory to. Yes. Anyway, one of these players is, according to the file description, drunk, so it's a bit difficult to tell who it is, but the game is called 2v1 and 1 drunk. But yeah, so keep that in mind. Someone might do something incredibly stupid, but at the moment it looks pretty standard. Scouts, interceptors there for Reki. Over here, much the same. Scouts, interceptors, light corvettes. Over here, again, scouts, and oh, are those repair corvettes? I believe they are. Which, you know, we see sometimes from every now and then, and we're not seeing any support frigates, so it looks like Pack of Marbs has decided to try something a bit different. Unless he wants them, you know, to absorb shots or to kamikaze or something. But if they're just in the healing role, then this could be interesting actually. If he has one assigned to each group of three corvettes, that could be a, well, we'll have to keep an eye on that and see how well it goes for him. And yeah, over here, light corvettes, scouts, support frigates, harvesters. I mean, how many different ways can I say it? So yes, this is the period of time when not a huge amount happens. Interceptors are always nice to see. And hopefully things should kick off fairly soon, because as you can plainly tell, I've completely run out of things to say. Which is always a danger, and yeah, there's not a huge amount I can add really. And if we look at this point of view of the map at the moment, we can see already that sort of the red team is making a distinct claim for these resource packets. Pack of Marbs is just sort of hanging back, and a Time Lord here has decided now to sort of claim this. This packet here, and he might, hopefully, please can this kick off now, because this is just terrible commentary. No, no, come on, he's just there, you can just fly over and kill him. And he's probably waiting for all his ships to get together. And we've seen what can happen before if all your craft are kept into this formation. You know, a couple of kamikazing scouts or probes, and suddenly this is going to be a very different game, but we're not seeing that out at the moment. We are seeing one or two probes actually doing what probes are meant to do, but it's not terribly exciting, to be honest. And so Time Lord has just started harvesting this patch here, whilst his sort of opposite number, this was Reki, wasn't it? We decided, yes, Reki has gone for this central patch, which is a lot more safer, although it will take his ships slightly longer to get there. And Although if his fleet is here, that is quite a strong position since he can move here to defend or join up here to sort of gang up on Pack of Marbs, whereas the fleet, or the, well, the Strikecraft here would have a lot longer, lots of longer travel time if they want to go all the way over to help out Pack of Marbs. Although it's scouts and interceptors, so they're still going to be pretty quick. But a few seconds can always mean the difference. And it looks like that Reki decided to try to fly over to, who was this again? Adriko, and then sort of changed his mind as he was spotted by Timelord. And we keep an eye on these numbers here, and sort of also an eye on the explosions. You can see he's only lost a handful of scouts, maybe four scouts now already, and I think there's been quite a few more explosions than that. So that's unfortunately the best way we can tell who's getting the hits in. But at the moment, I think it's too hard to tell. There's this huge Corvair force, well not huge, just nice Corvair force here, which is managing to stick together, and I think outnumbers this, actually maybe not outnumbers this Corvair force, but this Corvair force has the two support frigates that'll help keep them alive, so it could still go either way. And in fact, although it's really hard to tell with the scout numbers who's going to win. And over here you see once again the initial kamikaze attacks. We have lots of defenders at the back, which is exactly where they should be. Just now they're going to just open fire and start throwing in a fairly large amount of damage. Repair corvettes moving in, no support frigates for Pack of Marbs, support frigates for Adriko, was it? Adriko, yes. So he's going to have... That is a lot of ships for Pack of Marbs. And over here we can see Reki has sort of won that fight. He's maybe it was more of a draw, but either way Time Lord has withdrawn, and Reki has sent some of his ships over here. We can't tell Reki's ships apart, we can't tell which ones are his and which ones are Adriko's, because they're both almost the exact same colour. But yes, that's going to pretty much turn up into a fairly big fight. Meanwhile, over here, Time Lord, after withdrawing, has gone in again, straight for the mothership, or at least for to hit the reinforcements, and he's actually got quite an okay force here. If there's any reinforcement ships that would be really useful for him, and there are, which include two attack bombers, and that will actually start to threaten the support frigates and whatnot, and he should probably go after these craft here. What are they? Let's get a closer look. Just two scouts and interceptors. Meanwhile, in this fight, I think Pack of Marbs is managing to keep his units alive, keep everything together. There aren't that many enemy scouts there, and this corvette war, let's see if we can get a closer look, but it's only light corvettes. And at this point, with interceptors and defenders, they are defenders, aren't they? I've already said what they are this once this game, and the names just slipped my mind. But with all these fighters in, they may be able to do quite well against this Corvette force. It's a bit difficult to tell what's dying, but certainly I think some of those explosions were from Pack of Marbs. So we'll have to just keep an eye on it over there. Still producing a lot of units, so yeah. Meanwhile, over here, this isn't necessarily the most deadly force. But one thing it is doing is keeping a lot of Reki ships back. It's keeping five support frigates, two assault frigates, and while I don't think Time Lord will sort of win very well, Reki's sort of stuck and up in. He really wants those up here, or at least he really wanted them up here about 5 minutes ago. Okay, maybe not 5 minutes, maybe only about a minute, but yes. So without some help, I think Pack of Marbs is going to start dominating over Adriko fairly soon. Adriko still has ships available, but just not enough. He's got interceptors, which is nice, but now he's going to start losing harvesters, and that's just going to mean it's harder and harder for him to sort of gain control, gain superiority in this area. He needs help from Reki. Reki, however, is sort of hunting down these support frigates, or this support frigate and these corvettes. to esophagus. These insectors are going to be very nice. And we can see a gravel generator come out, which we've seen in a couple of games recently, doing a huge amount and being very, very useful. But against this force, a lot of these ships can just fly away. So we'll have to see how well he does. And lots more sub bombers, light corvettes and whatnot, ready for Timelord. Meanwhile, over here, a pack of mobs still doing well. Skinning down these harvesters. I think he's killed one, maybe two, but there's three left. This one's damaged, but he's not focusing it down. And there's three support frigates that are going to be doing their best, or should be doing their best, to keep these alive. And what are these small craft here? They look like... those are just the interceptors. But they're not really being that useful. And attack bombers out as well for Adriko. So in fact, it looks like Reki is the only one who's went into capital ships with the assault frigates and lots of support frigates back up. And this is a Time Lord just... he's probably seen this by now, so I think he's actually just pulled over this way to try to avoid it. And he does have this force here, which can actually is quite dangerous. He could swing in down here. Probably best not to go for this group here, but he could actually go for the harvesters here, which would be quite dangerous. And he does start producing assault frigates as well. Pack of mobs, and he's been joined by a few ships of Time Lord. A couple of interceptors and an attack bomber. And possibly these as well. And that's just going... they've just got to hope that they can clear up everything of Adriko's before the gravel generator arrives. The gravel generator gets here and locks down all these, it's going to be GG pretty much. But they've already started. The gravel generator has caught these five light corvettes, which it's not the end of the world. And these support figures are escaping. But it's a taste of things to come. But honestly, it does look like the green and yellow team, as it were, has sort of secured this area. There's still these ships they need to deal with, so it's like another wave coming in from Adriko. But if they can just kill that without getting in a grav well, they'll be fine. And as I said, you can just come down here, which is what Time Lord is now trying to do. He's a little outnumbered. There's two assault frigates here, assault frigate here, four support frigates here. If these four support frigates stay with this though, he could do it, but they're not, they're swinging around. And yeah, the assault frigates of Time Lord are going for this gravel generator, which I'm not sure is that worth it, because there's two of them and then might not be able to kill it with four support frigates. So it's going to be quite difficult, I think, for Time Lord to sort of gain control of this fight here. He hasn't lost it yet, but I think he's got a few decisions to make. Meanwhile, yeah, the allies, green and yellow team, Time Lord and PackofMarbs3, are dominating here. I like how Adriko is sort of continuously throwing ships into the fight, staying in the fight, keeping his harvesters, or at least some of them, alive, and just distracting this force from doing any sort of economic damage, or, well, they can't really go over here and help out. But yes, it might look like Adriko is losing horribly, but he's tying up a lot of ships. The question is, how long can he keep that up for? His last harvester is getting a bit hammered, and all these strikecraft look like they're just seconds away from winning. Over here though, I mean, his force is now having to peg it quite quickly. First support figure looks like it's going to go down pretty soon. These assault figures don't quite have enough damage, in fact. And I think some of them are hitting these. Oh no, that's just enemy fire from these. So yes, they don't have enough damage to kill this off. But once... I'm expecting iron cannons to come out pretty soon for Reki. Is that a third gravel generator, or is that a second? Okay, we've only got two out there, so... yeah. So back here, This is just now PackofMarbs3 clearing up the last of Adriko's ships. The mothership does have a lot of hit points, it has a lot of guns, and these are only strike craft, so I expect it to get a couple of kills before going down. Otherwise, Timelord has decided to bring his ships back. Might be a bit of a mistake, actually, if these gravels start activating. I mean, these are getting some good hits in on these support frigates, but honestly, why aren't these locking them down yet? Okay, Adriko has died, and that explosion just destroyed all of PackofMarbs3's ships, in fact. And he's still got the harvesters, still got one harvester, but otherwise he's just lost his fleet, and that's the danger of killing the mothership with Strikecraft. You see, half of these ships are now locked down, and this half is also getting locked down. So, it's still, I think it's 50-50. I mean, if PackofMarbs3 can get into some non-Strikecraft ships, I think he can come to Time Lord's aid and really help out there. And I don't think Time Lord is out of this fight yet. He's still got a lot of frigates. He's got Iron Cannon frigates out, so is his opponent. So it's quite even, in fact. It's just that there's these Scrabble generators that are keeping the Strikecraft advantage from doing anything. I mean, these Strikecraft stragglers here could honestly just go and start hitting some of these other resources, or go for the research ship, or just try to find something useful just to get the money's worth. And over here, I don't know how it's going to go. Ships on both sides exploding every so often. There's two Iron Cannon frigates out for Reki, but two out for his opponent, and there's still level generators. So, okay, let's get a bit more analysis out. There's useful ships at the moment. It's 5 assault frigates and 4 support frigates for Time Lord. His opponent has, let's see, 2 support frigates there, 1 assault frigate there, and so it's 4 assault frigates. So that's actually pretty even. I think Reki is 1 support frigate down, and maybe now 2 assault frigates down. So who knows which way it's going to go. And this is what Reki has to fear, though, is the frigates. Once those arrive from PackofMarbs3, this is going to end pretty quickly. They're going to just come in here, take out the gravel generators, and then all these ships are going to become useful again. And once that happens, it's going to be pretty much over. And I mean, Reki is harvesting here as well. Oh, yeah, he is harvesting. I don't know if Time Lord. What does Time Lord have in terms of harvesters? Well, nothing there, and I can't see any ships anywhere else. Oh yeah, see, actually, if I remember correctly, he has 2 harvesters here, and I think harvesters can dock with allied ships. So okay, so his economy is also pretty fine. So this is slowly flying out of Reki's control, really. I think now we can actually quite clearly see his frigate's forces are slightly outnumbered. And you can always, I think, tell when they're outnumbered, when they're sort of scattered around. The guy who's outnumbered tends to group all his ships together. But maybe Reki can still just about win. And there's always kamikaze attacks, there's always getting a destroyer out or something, but even a destroyer is going to struggle against 5 frigates here. Still a gravel generator flying around. And now these frigates are going straight for the harvesting operation of Reki. I think this is going to be the last stand of Reki. It was a nice attempt. Good timing with the gravel generator. But I just don't think he had the economy to pump out enough frigates to sort of take out Time Lord when he needed to. He's still got a fair few ships, and this gravel generator has managed to survive. He's sort of now going to be doing his last stand sort of down here, caught between two enemy fleets. So let's see if we can get a nice view of it. Three ships left. So yes, I think it is all over now. So, congratulations to Timelord and PackofMarbs3. Commiserations to Reki and Adriko of the clan FL. Whoever was drunk, congratulations, I couldn't tell. So clearly they are either a very good homeworld player or a better homeworld player when they're drunk. More frigates coming out. Salvage corvettes kicking off over here. Yes, it's always nice to see. They seem to be... I believe it's these salvage corvette pilots who are drunk, as they're struggling quite a lot there. So that's one mystery solved, and this is definitely a nice way to get rid of a gravel generator as well. Does it shut down as soon as you grab it? Okay, I want to keep an eye on that because I want to know if it shuts when it shuts down. Yes. Oh, and then it dies. I don't know if it died deliberately, but it did close up, as it were, as soon as the salvage corvette locked onto it, and now all these strike craft are going to get payback for the past 5 minutes where they've had to float in space and not shoot anything. So yes, thank you all for watching. I hope you have liked it. If you have, please like, subscribe, I don't know, do something else, whatever. Now we are. What's coming out of there? No, why would you? Well, okay. He did need another gravel generator, but he also really needed a destroyer or something. So yes. This shouldn't take too much longer. So for completionist's sake, I'm just going to stick around and continue watching this fight. I might get a bit closer. Maybe you can also hear the fight, which is something I've not quite been able to get right in the past few games, of the sound levels. You can sometimes see here these sort of electric sparks. This is because there's a dust cloud here and it sort of gets electrified when you fire iron cannon beams into it, and that's quite possibly why a lot of these fighters are dying, because it damages every ship inside the dust cloud. So this is actually these iron cannons are killing these ships. These fighters, although they're also taking some damage from this as well. So yes, this should be over pretty soon. At least I hope so, because I have to be off in 10 minutes. Derpy-derpy-derp. The mothership has so much health. Really, I have just run out of things to say. It should end any second now. And it was a good game. I enjoyed it. Could have gone either way for quite some time. I think even after Adriko died, it still... Reki had a small chance. But a chance nonetheless. Apparently he has an invincible one. No, there we go. Oh no. See, whenever something blows up, the camera shifts, so I keep on thinking that. There we go. Right. And goodbye.